But you know what? I'm somebody who's here asking for grace.
He was chief of staff for one of the most powerful Republican congressmen in the nation, and now he can't vote. Neil Votes worked for Ohio Congressman Bob Ney. Both pled guilty to accepting lavish gifts for political favors.
It was known as the pay-to-play scandal. The congressman went to prison. Voles was fined and put on probation. He's now a convicted felon who served his time and working to restore voter rights in Florida.
NBC2's Dave Elias talked to them about why he's behind Amendment 4.
Yeah, the man that's leading the charge to get 1.5 million felons the right to vote was a mover and shaker in Washington, D.C. back in the 1990s. And before getting caught up in the biggest scandal since Watergate, Voles paid his debt to society, but he still can't vote. And today he was at FGCU trying to change that.
This iconic symbol once home to Neil Voles.
I got to spend time with presidents and senators and leaders of foreign countries.
Chief of staff to former Republican Congressman Bob Ney of Ohio.
I want my success so bad that I'm going to cross lines to try and get there.
Putting his interest ahead of the public's.
I had clients who paid me a whole bunch of money to help influence our system.
Now he's trying to influence these students to give him the right to vote.
Would you still be passionate about this issue if you weren't a felon yourself?
I've been able to see it through a different perspective than maybe I wouldn't have if I didn't get the felony conviction.
He's seen here pleading guilty to conspiring to bribe members of Congress.
What do you say to people who've said, you did the crime, now pay the time?
Well, you know what? I'm somebody who's here asking for grace. People are more likely to be healthy members of the community if they're able to reintegrate quickly into the community.
Not all of the students, though, convinced.
I do still have concerns about it because I'm hearing mostly one side of it.
And not all willing to admit publicly they're against felons voting.
Another doesn't think felons should be allowed to vote because they don't follow the rules.
Voles insists, though, he now knows the rules, and he's using what he learned in Washington to help those just like him.
Hopefully now in a way that's very beneficial for people and for our state.
Now, Amendment 4 does not give felons convicted of murder or violent sex crimes the right to vote. It will need 60% of voters to approve it in order to pass. Live in the studio, Dave Elias, NBC.